The C-97 Stratofreighter was a heavy military cargo aircraft made out of former bomber designs such as the Boeing B-50 and B-29 Superfortresses. The iconic state-of-the-art B-29 was the only aircraft that used nuclear weapons during combat and was also responsible for dropping the atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. It was such a successful aircraft that Boeing decided to develop more versions out of its base design. One of them was the C-97 Stratofreighter, which had a unique look with a larger diameter fuselage upper lobe and a smaller one in the lower lobe, making for a double bubble section. The C-97 was first flown in 1945 and soon proved to be a highly successful aircraft. And even though 77 models were rolled out, a whopping 811 of its KC-97 tanker variant eventually became the backbone of the Strategic Air Command's early Cold War missions. Stratofreighter. After flying for the first time in 1942, the B-29 Superfortress heavy bomber quickly became a staple of the Allied fight against the Axis powers in World War II. This renowned four-engine plane was the progenitor of a series of Boeing bombers, tankers, reconnaissance, transport, and trainer aircraft. Around the time that the first operational B-29 took to the skies, Boeing began considering a cargo aircraft using the aircraft's wings, tail, engines, and lower fuselage, combined with an upper fuselage from another model. This double lobe-shaped idea was quite distinctive from other Boeing aircraft. The U.S. Army Air Force was impressed with the company's innovative proposals and ordered three prototypes. The C-97, a long-range heavy military cargo aircraft derived from the B-29 and the B-50, was the last aircraft in which Boeing President Philip G. Johnson participated before he passed away. The aircraft shared many design elements from both models, including the wings and tail. The Stratofreighter was designed towards the end of World War II. Its most iconic feature was a double-bubble fuselage consisting of two intersecting circular sections in which the 74-foot-long upper deck had a larger diameter than the lower one. It was designed as a large aircraft with a long wingspan, four engines, and a traditional tail. In addition, the aircraft's flight deck was placed in an elevated position at the front of the structure, but from the 10th aircraft onward, all C-97s were assembled with the taller fin and rudder from the B-50 Superfortress. The aircraft's cargo was accessed through a set of clamshell-style doors under its tail, where two retractable ramps would be used to drive in the load. With a total useful payload of 35,000 pounds, the aircraft could carry two regular trucks, towed artillery, light-tracked vehicles, six infantry, or up to 69 medical patients with staff. Its power was provided by four Pratt & Whitney R4360B Wasp Major Radial Piston engines with 3,500 horsepower. The Stratofreighter could reach a top speed of 375 miles per hour and cruise at up to 300 miles per hour, with a maximum height of 35,000 feet and a massive 4,300-mile range. Its empty weight was 82,500 pounds, and it ballooned to 175,000 with a full load. The Stratofreighter was also the first mass-produced air transport to have cabin pressurization, making long-range missions more comfortable for its standard four-person operating crew. It first flew on November 9, 1944, and a month later, it set a transport airplane speed record by flying an average speed of 383 miles per hour between Seattle and Washington, D.C., with 20,000 pounds of cargo. Operational history. The Boeing C-97 Stratofreighter entered service in 1947 during the beginning stages of the Cold War, a period marked by the rapid development of heavy transport aircraft. One of its first international missions was its participation in the Berlin airlift, in which the Western Allies flew American and British air forces over Berlin and dropped supplies such as fuel and food. The aircraft was operated by the 1st Strategic Support Squadron and suffered a landing gear accident. By the time it was repaired, the Soviet blockade had been lifted. The Stratofreighter also served during the Korean War, where it was primarily used to shuttle combat casualties, forming the backbone of the United States Air Force's military airlift transport service. During these escapes, the aircraft often flew at treetop altitudes to avoid the enemy. The C-97 would then serve in Africa, participating in the Biafran airlift in the late 1960s, delivering relief supplies during the Nigerian Civil War. Despite its successful career, only 77 C-97 Stratofreighters would be built before the world's first strategic long-range airlifter, the Douglas C-124 Globemaster II, took over in the 1950s. Tobogganing. Between 1951 and 1956, a new variant known as KC-97 was developed. The Strato Tanker was explicitly built for in-flight refueling, and a total of 811 aircraft were produced. As a transport aircraft, the Boeing C-97 could carry up to 68,500 pounds of cargo. In contrast, the Strato tanker was capable of offloading 15,000 gallons of fuel. The KC-97 used the flying boom refueling system, a telescoping tube with movable flight control surfaces that a boom operator extended and inserted into a receptacle on the receiving aircraft. After its introduction, all subsequent U.S. Air Force contracts were for tankers, as they were capable of serving as a heavy cargo aircraft without the need to remove the refueling gear. Soon after, the KC-97 became a staple of the Strategic Air Command, a United States Air Force major command responsible for Cold War control of nuclear forces. This Stratofreighter variant is considered an instrumental factor in providing the organization with intercontinental capability. However, because of the aircraft's slow cruising speed and low cruising altitude, the Air Force had to come up with a way for the Strato tanker to refuel jet engines. To achieve this, the aircraft would perform a tobogganing maneuver, where the refueling connection would be made at a higher altitude, and the bomber and tanker would fly down together, enabling the tanker to pick up more speed in the process. The KC-97 carried avgas aviation fuel to power piston engines, and also carried jet fuel for jet-engined aircraft. By 1957, the tanker was slowly phased out by another Boeing model, the KC-135 Strato tanker, a jet-powered aircraft with greater capacity. The last KC-97 and the first KC-135 actually rolled out of the Boeing assembly plant on the same date. Still, the Strato tanker remains in service to this day, 67 years after its introduction, and it is expected to fly until at least 2030. Other variants. In 1964, some of the KC-97 models were returned to tanker configuration for the Air National Guard, with two added jet engines to increase speed and altitude, while also making this massive tanker more compatible with jet aircraft. Although the last of the U.S. Air Force's KC-97 tankers were retired in 1973, they remained in use with the Air National Guard and the Air Force Reserves until the late 1970s. In addition to the KC-97 variant, the Stratofreighter also has a civilian derivative, the 377, a luxurious transoceanic airline that was operated by Pan Am Airlines. This aircraft was eventually acquired and modified by NASA to carry even larger loads. It became known as Guppy, Pregnant Guppy, and Super Guppy, and one of the models is still used by NASA today, with a capacity of 34,000 pounds. Meanwhile, several countries also had C-97s in their inventory. The Spanish Air Force acquired several models during the aircraft's prime years, and the Israeli Defense Forces adapted the Stratofreighter's airliner variant back into a cargo transport aircraft when they were unable to afford their preferred C-130. Angel of Deliverance. Only one full-sized C-97 remains airworthy. The Stratofreighter's serial number 522718, known as Angel of Deliverance, has been owned and operated by the Berlin Airlift Historical Foundation since 2002. According to its founder, Tim Chopp, the idea of repairing the Angel of Deliverance to fly it again often seemed inconceivable. Quote, "If you had to choose between a sharp stick in the eye or restoring a C-97 to airworthy condition, you might want to choose the stick, because it would be less painful." In 2012, as the aircraft was finishing its first round of repairs, Hurricane Sandy damaged the hangar and delayed the renovations. Finally, in November of 2017, the Boeing C-97 Stratofreighter flew one more time. The aircraft took off from Floyd Bennett Field in Brooklyn, stopped in New Jersey to refuel, and then continued its journey to its new temporary home in Reading, Pennsylvania. As was common with early Cold War-era aircraft, the Stratofreighter did not see many years of service, but its legacy lives on with the Angel of Deliverance, NASA's Super Guppy, and its presence in many countries' air forces. Thank you for watching our Dark Skies video. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to be notified of all our newest content. And if you have a specific aircraft in mind that you'd like to see in a future video, please let us know in the comments below.